Today's video, we are looking at Notion's brand new Evernote importer, and we're going to be looking into what it can do, what it can't do, and giving you a review of how to get started. So guys, let's dive in. So in the last month or so, Notion have added a brand new web clipper, and now they have this new Evernote importer. So from the perspective of Evernote users, this is looking very much on the up. You have the ability to clip stuff, and you now have the ability to import. Now, if you want to access this one, it's today's the launch date, so all you have to do is refresh your Notion account, and it should appear in the import area. Now, in this demonstration, I wanted to import one sole notebook, and that was our wedding planning notebook, so hopefully it will give you a full explanation of how to do this. So when you actually access the importer, you will get $5 credit to your account if you use the feature, so that's a huge bonus there. Now, all you need to do is press the importer button, and you will be brought to an authorization screen from Evernote. Now, once you sign into your Evernote account, you actually have to choose whether you're going to give it 1 year or just 1 day access. And of course, be happy with all of the access abilities they're suggesting. Now, once you've authorized your account, you will be prompted to select all of the notebooks that you want to import. In this case, I was just importing the Wedding 2018 notebook, but you could select or deselect all and go through all of the notebooks. There's also a little search bar there too if you're looking for a specific notebook too. Now, once you hit import, it will begin importing all of the individual notes into a database view. In this case, it was actually a list view. And of course, you can change the view of the database to gallery, to table, and many more viewing options. Now, they automatically sort it based on the descending order of the creation date. And you can change that up in the top right corner. And if you wanted to as well, you could change the filter too, as well as select on when it was last updated. Now, in terms of the original notes imported pretty well. I noticed that all of the lists imported well. Some of the tables that I pre-created in Evernote transported really, really well. And all of the image came across too. So here's a few examples of that. Now, one thing to note as well is the emails that I forwarded into Evernote didn't transfer fully across. I'm not sure this is beta edition, but if there's any notes that the team let me know about, I'll include them on the screen now, as of course this was a beta version I was playing around with and definitely pre-launch. So from general opinion, I did think this import worked actually pretty well and it did surprise me. I changed it to gallery view and all of the images came across full bleed, which was pretty nice. And in my opinion, it's pretty good in terms of what it has the ability to do. The good thing as well is if you had any tags associated to this, you can re-add them, but I'm not sure the import actually collects that and brings that on board as a property. So I do apologize, I did a little bit of a test with an old accounting module that I did at university, and it looks like the tags imported pretty well. And you can of course toggle them on and off using the properties area. So the good news is tags do import too. PDFs as well, I noticed, were in the same Notion format. Of course, you can open them up inside of a web page and access them there. Now, one thing I was pretty impressed with is if you do want to go back to the importer at any given time, you can quickly re-import stuff quite easily. So if you wanted to trial this with just one of your areas, then you can do that and then reselect everything and re-import it. Do remember, it will probably take you a bit of time to reorganize everything in terms of putting it in the right pages, but the good news is all notebooks will transfer across in this list view. Now, if you want my opinion, I was pretty impressed by the way that they Evernote imported this over. As you can imagine, it was something that I thought would be a bit tricky, but it looks actually pretty good. And I think when you guys get the launch version today, it probably will have most of the bugs fixed in it. Other thing to note is it's great that you are able to get new credit from this. $5 is great. You can also access new credit just by going to the web clipper, which is $3, and also accessing the system share on the iOS and Android apps for $3 too. That's one of the huge bonuses, and collectively that's $11 if my maths is right, which will give you pretty much a free month on Notion. Do remember as well, if you're on the free block plan, this is probably gonna knock you over that, especially if you're adding in plenty of notes. What I particularly liked about this as well is you can see how many notes you'll be importing per notebook, which is something, a very small detail, but something super valuable in case you didn't want to go over that block limit. So guys, let me know in the comments what you thought about this experience. It'd be honestly great to hear. So guys, thanks very much. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.